Okay, Aki Karim here, BBTB. I'm here with Marvin Greaves over in Oldham.
Yes.
I put you on the spot here because I've literally
put me
just
on the spot.
I was in the area. I had to drop some off somewhere, and I come over here. And but you're ready for action, aren't you?
I'm ready for action. Good to go. Put it on the spot. I'm ready. I'm ready.
Right. So you've had a couple of bits of news recently. Firstly, best wishes to Jake Andrews.
Yeah.
Who had to pull out of a fight recently. He's been ill.
Yeah.
Basically.
With pneumonia. Yeah. Unfortunately, yeah. So he was training. I think he had COVID in September, and then he thought that it was gone and everything was all right. Then he fought in October, and then in that last fight, what he had in the third round, he was seeing like he was gassing and he was finding it hard to breathe and stuff like that. And then obviously, a couple of weeks after that, he fell ill. Yeah, I mean, cut beef probably, so we went to the doctors and then end up having pneumonia at the end of the day. So he's only just come out now, he's at home, he's back with his family. So it's a little bit of a setback, but he will rest up and then we'll be back out again very soon.
Yeah, sending our best wishes to him there. And it was a good atmosphere in Oldham at his last fight.
Awesome.
Very good atmosphere.
Packed out, it was brilliant, yeah.
And Mikey Gomez Jr.
Fantastic.
I mean, he's the champ now, the Central Area champ.
Yeah.
And he'd done it in fine style against Sufi
Fine style,
Ahmed,
yeah.
And
the
to
stoppage.
Talk to us about it.
Yeah, well, basically, leading up to the fight, he was determined, like, I want to stop this kid. I've got a lot to prove to myself, everything else. So he trained hard. He was in here 24-7 doing his runs and all. That's it. And, like, he knew that he was going to stop Sufi. And he didn't know which round, but he knew that it wasn't going to go to the full 10th round. So he got the win, he got the fourth round stoppage, and it's all good from there. Now he's over the moon. He's having his rest till after Christmas, and then when he gets into the new year, we're going to get out there, get two big hard fights, like a good 10 rounders from Mexico or something like that, and then try and come in for more titles. That's
well, he actually did what he said he was going to do in the build up.
He did.
You know, he seemed like he's had a lot of frustration recently. The celebrations of his last two fights.
Yeah.
Like they've really
got a
bit between his teeth, you know?
Yeah,
what I mean?
Yeah, it does. He loses his head. He beats himself up sometimes, his confidence needs to build it. Even though he'll have a good performance, he will come out and say, nah, that was rubbish, that I need to do better. But that's his confidence building with Gomez. But yeah, he's up there now, he's on the map. You know what I mean? Like, he's put his heart and soul into the game now. I've got that fire back into him, so it's all good news from now.
Yeah, and you know, the thing with Mikey, I always thought that if he got a bit of a roll, a bit of consistency, then that's exactly what he needs, and it looks
definitely
like that's what he's going
to
have.
Definitely,
now.
yeah, because with Gomez, it was hard to try and get him back into the game, you know what I mean, because he liked going out, he liked going watching this football, but I said, if you want to do it, you've got to do it now. We waste all the time back in the days, so it's all about hard work, dedication. He's showing that, and he's showing massive improvement.
Yeah. And now he's got the title. There's people that are already waiting to fight him.
I looked on YouTube. There's about 3 or 4 guys calling him out. But listen, you're going to get that. People want that title, don't they? But as long as we're keeping training, he's an hard kid to beat because this relentless pressure with him. We still got things to work on, but we all do. It's boxing, isn't it? But yeah, we're ready. We're good to go.
To be honest, the last few years I've stayed away from all call-outs, this and call-outs. But to be honest, I suppose at the end of the day, everyone needs an opportunity. People want to fight each other. And you know, we all need each other in a sense, don't we, to make fights happen. And
And that's what boxing's about, isn't it? Like, you fight the best. Yeah, I mean, whoever's up there, we take the fights. Yeah, I mean, hopefully we will come out on the win all the time. You know what I mean? He's been underneath me. He's not had a loss yet, so it's all working. It's all working, mate.
How far do you think he can go?
I think he can go. If he keeps focus and keeps doing what he's doing, he will only improve. So I think he can go on British level, international, most probably world level as well, if he's smart and dedicated and keep doing what he's doing. I think he can go all the way, definitely. He's looking a lot more dangerous now than he was back in the days, and everyone's saying it, like, you're a different fighter, everything else. So people are recognising that, like, what he's actually got as a talented young lad.
Well, good luck to all the boys here. And how's it going in the gym?
Gym's firing. The kids are coming in. The community's coming in. We're all helping each other out, trying to sort people's mental health out, everything else. So it's busy at the moment.
Talk to me about mental health, man, because obviously, I'm a teacher as well, and I see a lot of that, and I take it very seriously.
Well, with the mental health situation, this is what this gym's been about. Rehabilitating people, kids from off the streets from 11 years ago. So people were coming from the community, just struggling through mental health, more with bullying, but now it's with the lockdown, it was rife. As soon as the lockdown started, a lot of people started coming in saying that I can't be at home, I need to be out. It was doing the heads in massive. So they're coming here, keep fit, you know what I mean? Take the mind off the negative stuff, turn it into a positive, and it's been a good outcome.
Yeah, listen, if you're in the Oldham area, and is it Chadderton?
Yeah, it's Onlywood Chadderton, yeah.
If you're around this area, come down this gym, because, you know, the door's open for you. And that's any boxing gym as well, isn't it? You know, gyms are just like a great place to go.
Yeah, it sorts a lot of things out. People just think it's just coming in and fighting. It's not. It sorts a lot of mental stuff out, physically and mentally, you know what I mean? So, and it's a good mentor, especially if you've got like good coaches in and good people around you. I mean, it helps them even more. So we're all about that.
Well, look, it was nice to drop in there. Like, thank you. Took you by surprise,
innit? Yeah, but we did it. No worries, Aki.
All right, bro.
All right.
See you later.
Thank you, brother.